Dear viewers, I am Frederick at BookWidgets, and in this video, I want to talk to you about what we believe to be a very exciting and powerful addition to the arsenal you have at your disposal within BookWidgets, the Word and PDF importer. You heard it right. It is now possible to import questions from a Microsoft Word or PDF text file straight into BookWidgets. Although it isn't a magical one-button solution that'll convert one to the other in fully automated fashion, we are convinced that this feature can save you loads of time when it comes to digitizing your paper quizzes and tests. Here's how you do it. I am now in my BookWidgets account on the My Widgets page. I choose to create a new widget, and when it comes to selecting a widget type, the importer works for the well-established triad of quiz, worksheet, and split worksheet that you are likely familiar with. So, choose any of these types. In the editor, click the gear icon in the top right, and there you'll find the option Import from Document. Now, it's important to realize that the importer only works with Microsoft Word's DOCX extension on one hand, or PDF on the other. If your document has another format, for example, a Google form, first use an external conversion tool to turn your document into either DOCX or PDF. Another important remark is that a PDF document must be a text-based and not image-based PDF. If you're not sure which one your selected document is, first, open it in any PDF viewing program and see whether it is possible to highlight pieces of text with your mouse. If you manage, you're good to go. Once you've selected the desired document from your hard drive, it will be opened and displayed in the BookWidgets importer. Notice that the layout may vary from your original document. This is normal and nothing to worry about. We are going to convert it into a BookWidgets exercise anyway. Now, the ideology of the importer is that you can highlight bits of text from your document and then explain to BookWidgets which type of information you have just selected by choosing the corresponding label. It is important that the first thing you select is always the question itself and nothing else. So only the actual question, instruction, or opening statement that you provide to your students to inform them about what they need to answer or what they need to do with this part of the exercise. Limit yourself strictly to this, as the rest will come later. Note that in this video, I won't be showing off all of the question types available. Once you get the hang of it, though, you'll notice that the workings are always similar and intuitive. So I will just highlight a few question types to get you started. Our first question type in my demo document is a multiple choice question. I select the question, and as soon as I release the mouse button, a window will pop up where the only option, for now, is New Question. I click it, and then choose which type of question this is. Text multiple choice question. You'll see that when you pick your question type, the entire document is now placed within a frame. This is normal. To section the question off, simply highlight a new piece of text and select New Question. A new frame will be created automatically. In case you made a mistake, it is always possible to either choose a different question type by clicking the header text of any frame, or to remove the frame altogether by clicking the X in the top right corner. For our multiple choice question, we'll now highlight the multiple choice options. Each time, select a line and indicate that this is one of the multiple choice options. When you've selected every element that pertains to the question, either move ahead with the next question or click the Import button in the top right corner. While the entire remainder of the text is still within the frame, the importer will only import those elements that you have specifically labeled, nothing else. So, either click Import to add the questions to your widget, or click Clear and Import to replace potential other questions in your widget by the new ones. Keep in mind that the document we are currently importing was originally a paper test or quiz. So that means that the only things we're importing are questions. While the power of BookWidgets lies in its auto-grading and auto-correction feature, this information is not contained within the document, so we'll need to configure it first. For a multiple-choice question, this means ticking the box or boxes that contain the correct multiple-choice option. The next question type is a single-line text question. This is probably the simplest question. Highlight the question and label it appropriately. Note that your document is likely to feature a solid line or perhaps a row of dots intended for students to write on. It is not necessary to also highlight this part. If you do, it will be interpreted as part of the question and it might look silly afterwards. All right? Our next question type is a fill-in-the-blanks question. Here, you have two components to select. Again, the question itself, and then the text that has the blanks in it. An interesting thing is that BookWidgets will recognize and convert these blanks automatically. You can see that the blanks have already been converted to the double angular braces that you need to configure a blank space in BookWidgets. And all that's left to do now is fill in the correct answers and potentially edit the layout where necessary. Then let's have a look at a mark sentence question. Again, highlight the instruction first and then mark the remainder of the actual text as such. Here, you may want to pay attention to the fact that your instruction, your original instruction, which was intended for a test or an exercise on paper, may not make sense in this new context. While my document instructs my students to underline the words they need to mark, afterwards, keep in mind that they will just have to click the words with their mouse or potentially on a touch screen, tap the screen in BookWidgets later. So you may need to adapt your phrasing. Also, bear in mind that for now, we've simply imported a plain text. It will therefore still be necessary to configure which words need to be marked in it. The next question type I'd like to have a look at is a text drag and drop question. While on paper, it is not possible to have your students perform a text drag and drop, you can convert a fill-in-the-blanks question to a digital text drag and drop question within BookWidgets. Just like with the fill-in-the-blanks question type, the blanks in this text will also be recognized and converted automatically. The only difference is that as your original document is likely to contain a list of words, you still need to cut and paste the draggable words into the designated text fields. And voila, done. A fill-in-the-table question is very easy to do. As always, select your question or instruction first. Then, highlight the entire table and mark it as a table. Finally, in the editor, configure your table. As opposed to a fill-in-the-table, a question table may require a little bit more information. First, you select the question, as always. But then, additionally, you need to define which items are rows and which items are columns of the table. I select the word true and identify it as a column. I do the same for false, and then I mark every single statement in the table as a row. Do this separately for each statement. In the editor, all that's left to do now is indicate the correct answer for each statement by placing double hash signs behind it, followed by the appropriate column header. Next, let's have a look at a very popular question type, an annotate picture question. Highlight the instruction, choose the appropriate question type, and then select the picture, marking it as a picture. Do not confuse picture with question picture. The first one is the picture type that will allow you to create text fields on. If you select question picture, on the other hand, then it will be imported as an illustration that simply accompanies the question or instruction, equivalent to an image you would add there through the rich text options. All right? Now, the importing part for this question type is easy. But in terms of configuring the question in the BookWidgets editor, I would like to give you a few pointers. Firstly, your image is likely to contain indicated text boxes as part of the image file already. BookWidgets cannot recognize these. It will therefore be necessary to add additional text boxes regardless. This video will assume you know how to do that. Create the text boxes on top of the already existing text boxes and label them appropriately so that automatic grading will be possible later. However, if we look at the result now, you'll see that we've obtained new BookWidgets text boxes on top of the indicated boxes already present in the image, and this looks sloppy. To counteract this, in the editor, go to Field Display Options and set both the Input Border Style to None and the Background Style to Transparent. If we preview the result again, you will see that the BookWidgets text boxes are no longer visible. However, they still provide the interactivity needed to write within the indicated field. Abracadabra. Magic. Next, I would like to take you through a picture ordering question. As you may have guessed meanwhile, select the instruction first and label it as a picture ordering question. Then, label your pictures one by one. This question type can be a bit tricky though. BookWidgets is all about you providing the correct answers and your widget taking care of the rest. For a sorting question, whether it be with images or with text, this means that you provide the correct order, and BookWidgets will automatically shuffle that order before presenting it to your students. But per definition, your pictures will not be in the correct order within your document, because otherwise the question wouldn't make any sense from an educational point of view, right? The pictures, however, will be imported in the same order as they are in your document, even if the order you select them in is different. It will therefore be necessary to still sort your images correctly, which may prove challenging because of the file names that are generated automatically. It is therefore advised to pay close attention when importing this question type. When your pictures are in the correct order, last but not least, adapt your instruction, if necessary, to fit the new digital screen-based environment. And the final question type I'd like to show you today is the preeminent choice for STEM educators, the equations question type. The equations question type essentially works like a fill-in-the-blanks question type, so the first thing you do is select and mark the text with the answer fields in it. But the really exciting thing about the equations question type is that if you've got special symbols or scientific notation forms, like the square root symbol you see here or the fractions of the last question, they will be interpreted correctly and converted into a LaTeX string automatically, which will undoubtedly save STEM teachers a ton of fiddling around with the code in order to obtain the desired outcome. Note, however, that the more complex the notation is, the bigger the risk will be that there is some interpretation error in the LaTeX conversion, so make sure to always review the result by clicking the preview button. Excellent. Within each question, always be sure to go over the correction and scoring options. The other options you find here, such as the rationale, the hint section, or a general image for the question, you can also import those. The way to proceed is always the same. Select the element in your document and choose the corresponding label. We are sure you'll get the hang of it in no time. When you're finished configuring the individual questions, make sure to go over the rest of the widget settings as well. The title reporting tab, the general tab, etc. And, obviously, don't forget the widget title in the top left. Configure the widget as you please, and share it with your students as normal. And that's it. Please do note that not all of the question types available within book widgets are also supported in the importer. Here is an overview. Recapping, only DOCX and PDF file formats are supported. If you have another file format, please use an external tool to convert your document first. Import your questions, and don't forget to add the answers where necessary afterwards. Only that way, you'll be able to take advantage of BookWidgets' auto-correction possibilities. Aside from the questions, don't forget to configure the rest of the widget as well. Should students be able to send in their results? Should the widget have an exam timer? Etc. And that's it. We hope you enjoy the importer. If you have questions, don't hesitate to reach out to support@bookwidgets.com. And if you like this video, consider subscribing to the channel. Thank you for watching.